Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Baik, semoga dinyalain kameranya ya. Kemarin kuliah dengan Pak Satrio digabung dengan kelas lain atau sendiri kelasnya? Bagaimana?
Dua kali pertemuan digabung, Bu. Sisanya sendiri.
Oh, dua kali pertemuan digabung. Sebentar, sebentar. Digabung dengan kelas sebelumnya, kelas A sampai D.
Iya, Bu. Benar.
Oh, selebihnya sendiri. Baik. Oke ya, ada sudah ada ini Fatima ya. Hello Fatima and hello all, how are you? How are you? Gak ada yang jawab nih. Is it all student in here? Is in a good condition or not, or you are sick? Can you please respond my question?
Yes, miss.
Okay, semoga baik-baik aja semua ya. Sebentar. Okay, is it visible, my PowerPoint slides?
Yes,
yes, miss.
Okay, thank you so much. Okay, I open this meeting today. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
This is actually the last class because in one semester there is a 14 meeting. We already finished 13 meeting, and this is the last meeting of biotic. And we will our final exam is on Friday. On Friday at 8 p.m. o'clock. So please be ready for the final exam. The material is integrated pest management and urban pest bedbug, and the other material is material from Bapak Radi Alfitra, urban pest. So we have two material for the final exam. Okay, I hope you understand. And I remind you that we have a summer course program, and today is the last. Day of the course. Sebentar. Okay, don't forget to join because this is a really good experience for you all, and I hope you can enroll the course. Okay, today we will study about the integrated pest management. Aldi, do you know what is integrated pest management? Aldi, please unmute yourself.
Yes, miss.
Okay. As you know, what is integrated pest management? Or in Indonesian, we call it pengendalian hama terpadu atau PHT. What is that?
Cara buat nanggulangin hama kan?
Yeah, you can. Hama. Okay, please you can speak in English.
Wait, please.
Anyone, please raise your hand if you want to add the information about integrated pest management. Okay. Aldi, time is yours. What is integrated pest management? Aldi, Kayla, yes, what is integrated pest management?
Integrated pest management is management aims to reduce pest population to below the level of economic damage.
Okay. And Aldi?
Integrated management is an approach that integrates different types of pest control methods.
Okay, this is actually how we can control the pest by using several techniques, such as biological control, such as cultural technique, mechanical technique, and also the last option is synthetic pesticide or chemical technique. Okay, and today we study about the urban pest. And the most important urban pest, especially in hotel, apartment, hostel and another is bed bug, and now we will study more about bed bug. Okay, let's see. We will finish at 10 o'clock, and I hope we can finish it on time. Integrated pest management, also known as integrated pest control. As I said, that this is the aim is to control controlling the pest by using several technique control, such as biological control. In biological control, we can use predator and parasitoid, for example. Do you know what is predator? Someone, please describe what is predator and the example of predator. Hanifa. Predator. What species that you ever know about the predator? Okay, Hanifa.
Predator is the one who catch or prey another animals.
Okay, and the example is.
The example is such as carnivore animals like lion or cheetah.
Okay, thank you. That is the example of predator. But I want to get the example in agriculture. Lion is too far from the agriculture sector. So the insect have many roles in our life. There is insect, the role is pest, and there is an order of insect that all of the species, the role is predator. What's that? Please someone mention the example of predator from insect.
Eagle, miss.
Yes? Eagle is not insect, please.
Ground beetles, miss.
Ground beetles, okay. Ground beetles, okay, it's predator.
Grasshopper.
Is that grasshopper biological agent? No.
Mantodea, miss.
Yes, good. Mantodea, mantide. It is the example of predator, yeah. And another example is parasitoid. Parasitoid is an insect that can interrupt the the life of insect, and usually they live in or on the pest. And the parasitoid mostly come from the order of Hymenoptera. Okay, yeah. And then the second one is if we want to use to integrate pest management, we can also do the habitat manipulation. What is the example of habitat manipulation? Please, someone give me example. What is the example of habitat manipulation? Please.
Rotation, miss.
Yeah?
Crop rotation.
Crop rotation. Okay, okay, good. Crop rotation. We can, to control the pest, we can rotate our crop. We can change the crop. For example, in this growing season, we plant paddy, and the next growing season, we plant maize, and the next growing season, we plant paddy. That is the crop rotation. Okay, another example, please. Habitat manipulation. Habitat manipulation is actually how to make the biological agent is comfort to live in the ecosystem. What we can do to make the biological agent really safe in our environment, and they comfort to live in that habitat. For example, in the last meeting, we studied about how to controlling the rat by using biological agent. What is the species? What is the species? The biological agent of rat.
Tito Alba.
Okay, good, Tito Alba. And what we can do to make the Tito Alba is comfort in the field? What we can do?
Make rubuha.
Okay, good, make rubuha. We make artificial nest. That we can. That is the example what we can do to manipulate the habitat. Okay, that is good, make rubuha. And another example. Who else can give me example? What kind of action of habitat manipulation we can do that make the predator or parasitoid is comfort in the field? What we can do? Okay. Okay, Aninda, do you have answer? Aninda, Arunisa.
Yeah.
Okay. I will help you all. Habitat manipulation that we can do to make the biological agent is comfort in the field is we can plant the refugia. Refugia is we can plant we can plant the sunflower, for example. So the plant that have a bright color, such as the sunflower, it will attract the insect, especially parasitoid. And they can attract the parasitoid, and the adult parasitoid, they can eat the nectar for their life. And for the predator, If we plant the plant such as the sunflower and another flower that have a bright color, it can be used as a refuge. Refuge itu adalah tempat berlindung, tempat bernaung ya. So we made the habitat for its predator or parasitoid. Okay, I hope you understand what I mean. And then the other is a modification of cultural practices. Cultural practices that we can use, such as we use resistant varieties, and we can use the good fertilizer, proper fertilizer, I mean. So do not too much using fertilizer, because if we use too much fertilizer, so our plant will be what's it? Will be easy to get the disease. Yeah. And then pesticides are used after monitoring indicates that they are needed. The goal, of removing only the target organism. So we should use the synthetic pesticide as the last option of controlling the pest. And the goal is only the target organism. Do not use the broad spectrum of pesticide. Broad spectrum itu adalah spektrum luas. Spektrumnya luas, jadi kita menggunakan narrow spectrum, ya, spektrumnya sempit. So the goal is achieved. We can removing only the target organism, only the pest itself, without killing the natural enemies. Okay, and then pest control material are selected and applied in a manner that minimizes risk to human health with a good using of pest control. We can minimize the risk of human health, because for example, if we use pesticide abundantly, so it is chemical and it is carcinogenic. Yeah, it will the farmer could be get the cancer. And then minimize the risk for non-target organism and then environment. Okay, another next slide. The principle of IPM, therefore, principle IPM that we should remember. The first one is healthy crop. How to make our crop is healthy? By using the good tillages. Good tillages itu adalah ini ya, apa? Pengolahan tanah yang baik, and then we use good seed, we use proper fertilizer, and then crop rotation and other example. And the second one, the principle of integrated pest management is using natural enemies such as predator, parasitoid, and other natural enemies. And then the third one is monitoring. Monitoring or surveillance is how we can observe our field, yeah, continuously. So in the field, there is no pest outbreak. It will not happen pest outbreak, because we always monitor our field. And then the fourth one is farmer as IPM expert. Please, Kevin, can you give me explanation about one of the principle of IPM? The fourth one is farmer as IPM expert. What does this mean, Kevin? Mau minum air putih? Ya, minum air putih. Oh. Kevin, please.
Wait, please.
Kevin tadi udah belum ya? Lupa saya. Oke, jawab sebisanya ya.
Arif, Arif. Anyone, please raise your hand if you already have an answer. Fatima. Yes, Diadema, okay. Diadema.
Farmer as a central role must be have a good knowledge to control the pest.
Okay, good. So the farmer should be have a good knowledge. How we can make sure that the farmer have a good knowledge? What the farmer can do to improve their skill, to improve their capabilities in handling the pest? What they can do?
Maybe like a discussion with the professional, like from we are student and farmer discussion.
Okay, good. Okay, what the farmer can do is by they can join the meeting, farmer meeting. In Indonesia there are a lot of penyuluhan. Bahasa Inggrisnya apa ya penyuluhan tuh ya? Lupa saya. Penyuluhan tuh apa?
Counseling, Miss.
Counseling. Oh, bukan istilahnya bukan counseling ya. Saya lupa. Penyuluhan ya, tuh Fatima tolong mengerti penyuluhan tuh. So the farmer can study about the about sebentar ya ini. Okay, the farmer can improve their skill by they can joining the farmer school. The farmer school or socialization by the government. Because the government, they have schedule. In one growing season, at least there is one farmer meeting. So in that farmer meeting, there are many not only socialization, but also there is a workshop. For example, how to make a rubuha, or how to make artificial nest, how to control the plant hopper, and then another. Yeah, so they can improve their capabilities in handling the pests. And then another. Let's move to the next slide, IPMS strategy. Before we can controlling the pest, what we can do is we should know the pest identification. Like what you have done in this semester, you collect the insect in the field, and now you already know the order of the insect. What is the mold type of that insect? You already know. And then where is their habitat? You already know. So after we know the pest identification, we can try to manage how to control that pest. Okay. The second one is monitoring and assessing pest number and damage. In each insect, there is an economic threshold. Economic threshold is threshold. Threshold itu adalah ambang ekonomi ya. Threshold itu adalah ambang. Economic threshold. So one pest, basically there is an economic threshold. For example, plant hopper itu adalah orang. Plant hopper, if we find 10 plant hopper in one paddy, dalam satu rumpun padi, we can use the synthetic pesticide. Yeah. So For example, we monitoring, and today we get 10 plant hopper in one paddy, so we can so the economic threshold is enough, 10 plant hopper per paddy. So the decision is we can use the synthetic pesticide. This is the example of economic threshold, the guidelines, and we can use there are many guidelines to handle the pest, and then we can use the management or control technique using combination of biological, cultural, physical, mechanical, and other technique. Yeah. Okay, we will study more about all of the control in the next semester in the subject of teknologi pengendalian hama. Yeah. Okay, and then evaluation. Okay, ecological information, what we can get from ongoing season. We monitor, we observe weekly what's going on in our field. And also, we need the information from the previous season. What is the pest and how is the abundance? Abundance itu adalah apa namanya, kelimpahan ya, banyaknya. Ya, we need all of that information to make decision what management that we can do in that field. Okay, this is there is action threshold. Like I said before, that many pet. Sorry, info ini. Bentar ya. Economic action threshold. So in pest, there is economic threshold. There is guideline how we can use the synthetic pesticide. And responsive action is action that can be made after we know that if it reach the economic threshold, so the action is, for example, synthetic pesticide. And the information from previous season and also the experience from the previous season, it's precious also to make the decision for the next growing season. So we can manage how the preemptive action. Preemptive itu adalah usaha untuk mencegah ya. Preemptive. Okay. And then IPM as tools of sustainable agriculture. What we can do is biological control, as I said you. There is a predator, parasitoid. This is in the right one. In the picture is all of the example of parasitoid. Parasitoid mostly comes from the order of Hymenoptera. So as you can see in the picture, there is an insect above. Yeah. There is a caterpillar, and then on above there is an insect. The yellow one, and this is the parasitoid. This is the adult parasitoid. And the metamorphosis is holometabola, complete metamorphosis. And this adult parasitoid is piercing their ovipositor into the caterpillar. Sebentar ya. Sebentar ya.
Okay, sorry for disrupt this meeting. My son need to go to the toilet, so I help him. Okay, the next. Okay, sampai mana tadi ya? Lupa saya. Sampai mana ya yang terakhir?
Sampai yang gambar nomor 4 bawah, Bu. Yang...
Oke, sip. Terima kasih, Fania. Oke, this is the picture. This is the caterpillar. Has been injected by this parasitoid. This parasitoid is deposit their egg into the caterpillar. So the egg will be inside the caterpillar. The egg of parasitoid will be inside the caterpillar, and then egg change into the larvae. The larvae is live inside the caterpillar, and then pupae. After several days, the larvae will come out from the body of the caterpillar. So the pupae will be outside the caterpillar body. And then after that, the pupae and then emerge. The adult emerge from the pupae. That is the life cycle of parasitoid. Okay, and this cultural, okay, and then the last one, this adult parasitoid, all of this adult parasitoid, they need nectar. They eat nectar. So they have strength to looking for the pest over the field. Ya kan, dia perlu kekuatan. Sebelum mereka mencari hama di lahan, mereka harus makan dulu. Makanya apa? Makan nektar. Cultural control, ya, practice that can reduce the pest population, pest reproduction, pest dispersal. For example, is changing irrigation practices can reduce the pest problem. Since too much irrigation water can increase the root disease and weeds. So all of the input in the agriculture, for example, fertilizer, for example, manure, water, and etc., should be used properly. And then the third one is mechanical and physical control. Right one, there is a picture. The yellow one is a sticky trap. This is the trap to catch the insect. For example, aphid. For example, aphid itu adalah kutu-kutuan ya. The order of Hemiptera. This yellow sticky trap, also can reduce the aphid in the field. Okay. We will practice this yellow stick trap in the next meeting. Fatima.
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay. How about the next semester? Do you is it still online or you will go to Indonesia?
Yeah, ma'am. They had told us to come on mid of the August or the early September to Indonesia.
Okay. Okay, so we can meet in here.
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Chemical control. Chemical control is using the pesticide. Pesticides are used only when needed. With combination with other approaches for more effective and long-term control. Pesticides are selected in a way that minimize the possible harm to people, non-target organism, and environment. And then, sebentar. Okay.
We use selective pesticide for so that will do the job and be safest for other organism and for oil, for soil, air, and water quality. Okay. Key benefit of using IPM. Yeah, we can lower risk to human health, and then the environment, lowers to environment, we will save the water, we can save the soil, and etc. Pollinating insect also, okay, yeah, because there is an impact. If we use synthetic pesticide, the impact could be in the pollinator. Pollinator is an insect that can pollinate the flower, pollinate the crop. Delay the development of pesticide resistance. Since we use pesticide, so there is always the risk of resistance. Yeah. So by using the integrated pest management, we can delay the development of pesticide resistance. Money can be saved. The agriculture should be give benefit. The benefit to the farmer, financial benefit, I think, and then improve public image of agriculture production. And then the last one, we study about the urban pest. I hope in the last 15 minutes, I could finish this lectures. Urban pest, for example, bed bug. Bed bug, adult bed bugs are very small and difficult to see with naked eyes. And fact of the bed bug, if we bite a bed bug, and then the reaction of the human body will occur 14 days later. Yeah, 14 days later after feeding. The symptoms of the body that have been attacked by the bed bug is like in the picture. Background, this insect is a bloodsucker. The species is Cimeclectularius, Hemiptera simicidae. And this insect is nocturnal. They prefer to feed on human blood in the night, primarily attack human. Okay, now more often in homes, apartment, hotel, hostel, and other facilities. This is how the bed bugs look like. Yeah, this is the bed bug in the mattress, I think, in the bed. This is the picture how bed bug when hungry and when they full. When hungry, the bed bug is circle shape and flat. And while if the bed bug is full, so the body will increase 5 times from the previous size. This bed bug is belong to the insect. So the insect, all of insect have metamorphosis. They also set their skin to grow. The metamorphosis is actually paurometabola, start from egg, nymph, and adult. In nymph, the molt is 5 times. They set their skins 5 times. Duration from egg to adult, they can be adult after 4 months. And this bed bug can live up to 18 months or longer without blood meal. So this survivability is really high. If they didn't get the blood from the human, so it still can be lived for up to 18 months. suck blood every 3 and 7 days, a half of blood meal is lost through the anus in the first 5 hours after feeding. So in the matrix, we can find the stain or the mark. Yeah, the picture, like in the picture, yeah, bed bug and their stain mark. Population density in 21 degrees Celsius temperature. If 40 bed bugs are in room, after 6 months, the population would reach 5,905 bugs. So it's too much. So we need to control this bed bug. The map is strange. The term is traumatic insemination. Yeah. What is the traumatic insemination? The traumatic insemination is a copulation behavior. Copulation behavior is a mating behavior. Why this is strange behavior? Because the male of bed bug is piercing the abdomen of the female, like in the picture in the right side. We can see in here there is a 2 bed bugs. The insect that piercing the abdomen, this is the male one, and the female one is on the other insect. Okay, yeah, they piercing the female abdomen with its genitalia and then ejaculate into the body cavity. The life cycle female may lay to 100 until 500 eggs in her lifetime. Habits, hiding in many places, feed repeatedly, and they can travel 1.5 until 6 meters, sometime until 30 meters. It depends on the transportation or depend to the travel of other people. Yeah, they easy to spread out. They spread. It could be through the public transport city. Public transport, such as bus, for example. There is a tourist from another country that have been infected by the bed bug, and then they carry the bed bug in their body, on the tourist body, or the bed bug in their suitcase or in the clothes or maybe in other place, and then they move through public transportation. Yeah, so that could be spread easily. Okay, the bug carry the bags, and then the odor, bed bug emit unique sweet and musty odor. Baunya apek. Yeah, it's not good. And then a guest visit who has come from such as infested environment. Yeah. So the bed bug spread easily from the guest visit who has come from the infested environment. And then the bed bug could be spread from buying used and furniture. Maybe it's in the overseas, yeah? Or picking up the discard bedding that have been infected by the bed bug and other. Okay, this is the picture of bed bug in the room. Sanitation alone will not eliminate this bed bug. So inspection should be really careful. We treat all the detected sites with the residual insecticide. Yeah, we can use insecticide and seal shut all cracks. Mungkin di temboknya itu ada pecahan, mungkin di belahan-belahan, apa namanya? Karena furniture ada banyak sela-selanya ya, itu harus diperhatikan juga. require multiple visits, and these bed bugs are very resilient, become problem again months after. Hotel, apartment. Sorry. Hotel apartment should not partially treat one floor because bed bugs spread rapidly from room to room through peep, vacuum cleaner, clothing in luggage and trolley and other. So if we should carefully to control this bed bug because this bed bug is easily moved from room to room. This is the news from overseas. This is bed bug detection dog in New York. Preventive bed bug inspection hotels. We can use the other company to control the pest. For example, the pest control companies, and educate all housekeeping staff, follow up the customer complaint, change the bed liner, and follow advice from pest management professional, and then another. Yeah. Many things that we can do. This is the inspection in hotel, not only in the bed, but also in all part in the room. We can inspect carefully. Also in the furniture storage, we inspect one by one. As you know that the 40 bed bugs, it's if we let them live, so it will increase abundantly. Do not remove anything from the infested room before inspection. Inspect likely hiding spot first around sleeping areas and another. Okay, this is the control that we can do using non-insecticide. This is what the pest control do by heat and more than 90 degrees Celsius the room in for 4 hours. And then this is we can use these tools. This is non-insecticide tools. And then we can use the sticky glue tape, solar tape untuk bagian-bagian sela-sela. Okay, ya, di vacuum, non-insecticide. Be ready to tear the room apart. And make sure that if we use the insecticide, make sure that that insecticide is not, is still Okay, as you know that DDT is already prohibited in over the world, so carbamates, yeah, and do not use carbamates. So we can use residual pesticide. And this is treatment residual by using the tools. Okay, this is the treatment dusting. This is the space spray, and we finish. The last assignment is resume. Okay, and please write the resume before Friday. And okay, we finish today. Any question before I close this meeting? Any question? Any question, please? No?
Bu, maaf.
Okay.
Boleh saya bertanya tapi pakai bahasa Indonesia or?
Silakan.
Bagaimana caranya untuk kita mengatasi membasmi bed bugs itu, tapi dengan cara kayak rumah gitu, Bu. Nggak usah pakai treatment, panggil treatment gitu, Bu.
Oke. Upaya yang bisa kita lakukan adalah kita bisa sanitasi di pembersihan secara menyeluruh terhadap rumah kita. Betul-betul diyakinkan itu nggak ada. Kalau bisa, kalau memang betul-betul terinfeksi, kasurnya dijemur. Pastikan betul-betul tidak ada. Kan yang namanya serangga kan ada telur, larva, pupa, ya. Seperti itu ya. Apalagi, telur itu kan tadi paurometabola ya. Berarti telur, nimfa, imago ya. Jadi mungkin ada telurnya kan kita tidak tahu juga. Jadi yang pasti sanitasi itu penting sekali. Ya itu sih yang bisa kita lakukan, tidak ada lagi. Terus mungkin kita bisa vakum. Nah, kok sekarang ada banyak ini ya, jasa-jasa yang rumahan ya. Kayak vakum tungau, itu pun ada kan, saya pernah dengar. Nah, itu mungkin bisa dilakukan juga. Kalau misalnya kita tidak punya alat untuk vakum itu. Oke, seperti itu. Ada yang ditanyakan lagi? Dan tidak hanya kasur saja yang dibersihkan ya, tapi ruangan di sekitarnya juga. Ada lagi pertanyaan sebelum saya tutup? Oke, ini ada e-presence yang harus kalian isi, silakan diisi. Waktunya 20 menit. Saya tutup, kalau tidak ada pertanyaan, nanti kita ketemu lagi Friday ya. Last exam, Friday at 8 a.m. So please be ready. Make sure that you finish all the assignment from me. Okay, yeah. Thank you so much. See you next Friday. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you, Miss.
Yo, sama-sama.